Hello, welcome to this episode of Makerbox Mondays. Today I'm gonna have a look at a filament from Innofil called ERP InnoPet. So it's a PET filament, not PETG. So let's have a look after the intro. So I believe that this is the first time I tested PET filament. That is not PETG, but just only PET, and I was really interested to see how that would fare. And so I printed out my break test samples and did a test and was really happy to see how strong it was. It was almost as strong in layer adhesion as PLA and much better than normal PETG that I've tested so far. So the break test and the layer adhesion tests came out excellent, and I'm gonna read out the label and have a look at that. So here on the label it says it's from Innofil 3D ERP InnoPet, and print temperature should be 210, much lower than PETG normally, and bed temperature 35 to 75, and speeds 30 to 70, so and cooling off or low, and I was testing with just 20% fan, just my normal PETG settings basically, except I lowered the temperature to 210. But here they say ERP InnoPet is made from premium food approved PET. PET is widely used in produced food and beverage containers and bottles. It's the same in Coca-Cola cans and soda cans. This high quality filament will give you outstanding printing results, good layer adhesion, high resolution and easy to handle. It has a natural, transparent, smooth look. ERP InnoPet can be 100% recycled, and more information at innofil3d.com. So that was the label, and I have to agree with the layer adhesion. It was coming out excellent. Sometimes filaments claim to have some properties, and and this I can validate. The layer adhesion was excellent, almost as good as my best PLA samples have done, so better than some PLAs even. So let's have a look at some of the prints I did. So first I did my maker coin, and I was getting really good results, and it came loose from the bed and the top part got all messed up but I was printing with 60 degrees on the bed, and after I had this issue I raised the temperature to 75, and that was good enough to get good bed adhesion on my PI sheet on my Prusa printers. But this print came out excellent, it looks really nice, and it's without any issues. There's a tiny amount of stringing, but nothing too serious. Mr. Belly came out excellent. Small amount of drooping here as usually. It's a very steep overhang, and I usually get one strand of drooping, and that's expected. But you can see the surface quality is quite nice. It's quite shiny, and the strength of the legs is quite high. Took quite an effort to break, compared to other filaments. It's quite strong. So you can see all the break tests I did on my test machine. It's very difficult to break, but then I printed zero layers a lot, and that one came out excellent. And as you can see, it looks really nice and no issues. A tiny amount of stringing, but nothing to worry about, and the overhang here in the hand was looking quite nice, so it's like really good looking filament. So to wrap this up, this Innofil ERP InnoPet was giving me excellent results. I was quite happy to see how strong the layer adhesion was for this filament. It was stronger than some PLAs even, and I was quite happy with that. And so the filament is like somewhat transparent blue color. It shines a lot and is very good looking. If you can get your hands on this filament, make sure you test it out. It was giving me excellent results. But this will be it for this video. If you like what I'm doing here on the channel, please subscribe and give this video a thumbs up and a comment. So for now, I thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.